Big Cat TV, Pastor Reacts, Pastor Andy with you along with Big Cat. Happy New Year, everybody.
Yeah.
And we're getting some stuff done today.
It's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a while. So not by our choice, but a lot of stuff happened. Yep. So without further ado, another Rage Against the Machine song, right?
No, I think this is our first Rage.
Okay.
Maybe I could be wrong.
Maybe I'm just listening to it on my own.
Did you see that?
Which one?
I know.
So much going on
here. Let me see if I can get it. Sorry, guys.
What?
I know. I saw that. I can't remember the song came out. It's not 2010, but it's been a while.
Wow.
That's crazy, huh?
That is. 2000 for two. That, no, oh, did he run in 2000?
No, this was. We'll have to look that up. Should have done a research before, but I saw that.
It's
like,
Reacts. Yeah. It's okay. Come with me until tomorrow. I'll drag you to your grave. I'm deep inside your children. I'm gonna swear you in my name.
Machine Rages On, or Rage Against the Machine. That band is anti-family, and it's pro-terrorists.
Yeah, did they really do that?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Hey, you know, that's kind of putting putting in motion, you know, what they believe.
No, yeah, that's definitely, I mean, that's good for that band, you know, sticking to the word.
It's like, the whole thing is like, okay, but obviously there are problems. What are the answers? I mean, that's one of the things that makes following Christ so difficult, is it's like, okay, problem here, problem there, problem here, problem there. Okay, but what are the answers?
Yeah.
What are the answers? Because if you take out the whole system, you just created potentially a lot more problems than what you had in the first place. Like AOC, Alexandria, Ocasio-Cortez. Oh, we went there.
Oh, man.
No, but she was talking about the, which I give her credit for her honesty. She's like, well, we should be taxing, you know, the 10th. If you make $10 million a year, then that 10th million dollars should be taxed at 70% or whatever. Yeah. It's like, okay, but then what happens to those people? Like, one thing for sure that happens, in my opinion, I'm not an economist, but those people that, once they get up to that level, they find a way to not be in the United States, you know? And that's one of the points that people are making. So it's a really complex problem. There are obviously people that are really gifted at earning a lot of money and making a lot of money. There's just people that are. And what do you do with those kinds of people in your society?
Yeah.
Because, like, money's like, you know, money's one of those things where you can just make it. And when you have it, it makes, you know, interest. It makes itself, which is really weird.
Yeah.
So, but as far as I was thinking about, because I've been studying a little bit about the value of, when Jesus was alive, there was the temple. In Jerusalem, there was the temple, and it was a huge, it was obviously a religious, you know, a religious center, but it was financially, it was a huge financial thing. One of the things that I, like, we think about this, you know, people trading, you know, Jesus turning over the tables and the money changers. Some of you may know that story, but some of the research that I've done says there's like 100,000 people living in Jerusalem at that time, okay? But during the time of these festivals, potentially 3 to 4 million people would travel there. Okay, so if you're a city, maybe some of you guys live in cities of 100,000. Imagine if every year, or multiple times a year, you would have 3 to 4 million, let's face it, they're tourists.
Yeah.
Coming to where you live. Yeah. I mean, that's... cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching. What are they going to eat? Where are they going to stay? All that stuff, right? And then you, if you can be, I mean, that's your, you're building this huge kingdom. And that's one of the, you know, Jesus came in there and said, look, this is not what you should be doing. And, you know, I don't know the philosophy of this band, but it's kind of like, you know, kind of like when you get a 2 or 3 year old or a 4 year old, and they'll see something wrong, and they'll start pointing out what's wrong, you know.
Yeah.
The window's broken. It's like, yeah, I know the window's broken. Just keep pointing at it, you know. But that's how I view some of this. Not that these guys are unsophisticated. I wonder about how sophisticated they are in terms of their solutions. Because I think when you do point out a problem, the adolescent response is to point out the problem. This is stupid. This sucks. You're dumb, right? Mm-hmm. That's what you start hearing out of adolescents. That's their identification. There's an issue here. Maybe you're a hypocrite. Be a little bit more sophisticated way of saying that, right? Or, you know, you don't do what you say, all that stuff. You don't follow through, whatever. But the adult version is like, okay, there's a problem. What's the solution? I'm not sure we got one in this song, and maybe that's not the point. Maybe the point is to wake people and shake them up.
Yeah, they might have had a solution, like through their following, you know, like,
possibly. Yeah. Maybe you guys know. Maybe somebody out there has the solution. AOC thinks she has the solution. She's... All right.
Kind of crazy that Donald Trump, though.
Donald Trump, you know.
That's just crazy. I'm guessing that's what...
Getting into politics now.
Yeah, great.
Like, subscribe. Love to hear what you think. See you real soon.